Are Bluetooth devices secretly killing us? To tell us more, we've brought on a researcher specializing in cancer.
We do reviews of many things Bluetooth. Smartwatches, cell phones, headphones. And if you want to see some of those videos, they're linked up on the screen or in the description down below. And my brother who watches the channel asked me, hey, are Bluetooth devices really bad for your health? Because I've read articles saying that they are harmful. Here at DHRME, whenever we have a question, we turn to an expert. So today we have with us cancer expert David.
Well, defining an expert is a difficult thing to do. I wouldn't call myself an expert. I will say I just read quite a bit about it and do some work about it.
Spoken like a true expert. So could you maybe explain a little bit about who you are and what it is that you do?
Yeah, okay. I'm from Costa Rica, so the San Jose para el mundo. But I came 5 years ago to the Netherlands to do my research and some studies here in the university. So now I'm doing my PhD, and it's mainly an association between the immune system and cancer.
Sounds like an expert to me.
But I'm not an expert. Not an expert.
So, David, can you tell us a little bit more about what the current state of the research is in this field?
Yeah, and I would say cancer is a disease that usually takes years to develop. So doing associations is a little bit difficult, especially when technologies are new, like Bluetooth is quite recent. So you still have to wait years to make a clear association between all the exposure we have and maybe a disease coming from it. But searching in scientific literature, I find, for example, an article that is quite experimental. They really tested, and it was in people that has a problem in the auditory nerve. So they have to do a surgery to expose the nerve, and they want to measure the response when you have one of these devices close by. Since nerves are connected, the way they send signals are electricity, so you can measure a difference in the electricity when there is a response. And they put a cell phone, GSM technology, close to the ear, and then they make a phone call. They saw the response, and what they saw is that there is a strong response, and at the same time, the responses after are slower. There is an effect there. But when you put a Bluetooth device, always connected to a phone, but this phone is around 50 centimeters away, like something distance between your pocket and your ear, they don't see a response.
Right.
So since a Bluetooth device doesn't start a response as strong as that, this is at least one experimental result that says there's a difference between them.
Yeah. So if people are using their cell phone, instead of putting it up to their ear, it's better to use an earphones or a Bluetooth headset.
Yeah, I would say that seems to be true. But it's also true that in this experiment, they have an open school. Mm-hmm. And usually you have their school is in between what is already thick, and ameliorate the signal, and also you have tissues, so the effect won't be the same that they measure. So it will always be lower, but they will always be lower in Bluetooth than in a cell phone.
I always use my cell phones with a closed skull. So interesting, you found one research which studied the effects directly. You also saw some other research. So what were your conclusions? What did the research conclude?
I would say what they conclude until now is that the Bluetooth doesn't seem to be harmful, or at least is a lot less powerful than the cell phone, for example, when it's active, close to your ear.
Okay.
And they mainly say it is because when you check the power that they have, the signal, the power of the signal they transmit is around 1,000 times smaller in your in the Bluetooth than in the cell phone.
Okay.
And if you want to understand this, it's like is comparable to a microwave. Like a microwave have a power of around 700 watts, and you know it's really powerful. Can go through your food, can warm up everything.
Yeah.
And when you go to a cell phone, it has around 2 watts.
Okay.
It's already quite a bit lower.
So 702 watts.
Yeah.
Okay.
And when it's active. Usually if it's not doing anything, the phone is lower than that. Two watts is the maximum, and it's basically the maximum allowed as well in the European Union, at least.
Okay.
But when you go to a Bluetooth device, at least the most recent ones, they are 2 milliwatts, what means 1,000 times lower than a cell phone. So that already tells you that it's a lot less powerful than many other things we use in our everyday.
Right. So if Bluetooth devices are a problem, we have some much bigger problems to deal with.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like your wireless router, all these kind of things.
What are some other things that could have harmful effects?
For example, if you think about these towers for transmitting high voltages that are usually in the middle of farms or mountains is for a reason, because the power around it is really strong, that magnetic field. So they prefer not to have people living around. There's not a direct conclusion, but they have been already been guiding that that's really powerful. Also, you have radiation coming from space. Most of them is blocked by the atmosphere, but you have that UV light that we all understand that UV rays are really strong.
Yeah.
And I would say that's one of the most powerful things we have around, and it's in our everyday life. So many other things around you have much more power than a Bluetooth device.
Also aliens.
To wrap this up, just because there isn't evidence saying that Bluetooth will cause cancer, it doesn't mean it's not harmful in any other way. Having said that, David, what would be your top three tips for our viewers who are concerned about radiation in general?
Well, I would say like number three, take some signal-free holidays once in a while. Like just go somewhere far so you don't have all these signals around you. That's also healthy for your mind and other things anyway. Mm-hmm. And number two, be careful with the other radiations like UV light. So use your sunscreen. That's really important. It has been proven it has an effect. That doesn't apply to you guys, for example. I mean, not to discriminate, but you are darker and there's evidence of that as well.
You're darker.
And number one, there is a lot of signals around you anyway, all these wireless routers and the use that other people around you give to the devices. So I will say just try to minimize it, try to use it in a good way, but also don't be paranoid.
It's a good point, because research actually shows that being paranoid is more harmful to your health than the radiation itself.
That's true.
You've heard it from the expert.
I'm not an expert.
I've read that eating cucumber can cause cancer.
Yep. I don't know, maybe to you.
Also aliens.
Yeah, and other things you have in your head. Yeah.
Nice one.